does, it makes you feel good, and it brings joy to your life. So not only are you helping other people, but you know, just as importantly, you're gaining an awful lot from it as well.
I think Best Buddies does a great job of, you know, just making one connection, one friendship for that person, and it can change their whole life.
Well, that is a video of just some of the stars who support the wonderful organization Best Buddies, which of course we love here at Fox 5, and the man who helped create Best Buddies, and as a result has provided thousands of one-on-one friendships for people with special needs, is joining us now. We are very honored to have Anthony Kennedy Shriver in studio.
Thank you. How are you?
Excellent. So great to see you again.
Yeah, pleasure to be here.
First of all, thank you so much for what you've done with Best Buddies. It's incredible.
Yeah, it's been a pleasure, and it's been an enormous team effort. You've been wonderful to us here in Nevada, and I know you've had your own buddy for 4 years, which is incredible. Hopefully other people will follow your lead.
Michelle. Hello, Michelle. She watches all the time.
Right.
She says you're, she has sign language, so she says you're very hot.
Hot? Oh, my God.
She's not afraid to flirt.
She needs to tell my wife that. I never hear that out of my wife.
You don't?
Never, absolutely not. Hopefully that'll rub off.
She says, Jason's funny cute, but you're hot. So you get a better compliment, okay?
No,
came to the Best Buddy Ball at Caesar's Palace.
I did at Caesar's, which is great. They donated the entire evening for us, all the food, the venue, and your buddy spoke, which I remember very well, and you were wonderful and added enormous energy. We raised a lot of money, brought a lot of awareness to Best Buddies, and I think Caesars has been great, and many of the casinos have been great. So we've been really fortunate here. And Jason Smith, who many people know, our state director, done a great job, raised tons of money, and brought our programs to many, many schools, and created those wonderful and important mentoring, friendship relationships that so many people with intellectual and developmental disabilities desperately need.
And it's so amazing. I don't know if people know your story, but you started Best Buddies back when you were in college.
Right. I know. I wish I was back in college.
You look like you're still back in college.
Oh,
come on, you look great.
God, I'm going to want you to be my wife by the time this thing's over.
Whoa! She's not watching this, she?
No, thank God.
But honestly, I mean, you started this, of course, your mom, I mean, with all Special Olympics and all the wonderful work your family's done. But Best Buddies is so unique because what people don't have in the special needs community are friends.
Yeah, it's huge. And I mean, I think what we try to say always, you know, imagine your life without your best friend, whether it's your husband, your wife, and how different it would be. And I think for people that are left alone, especially when they reach the age of 21, 22, when they get out of the school system, having a social network and someone they can count on, rely on, cry to, laugh with, is so vitally important for them to build their confidence and self-esteem, to really feel like they can do anything in the community. Whatever their dreams are, that friend will help them get there.
Yeah.
And I think we all need that kind of push and that encouragement.
Everybody.
Yeah, everybody. So I think, you know, it's been vital and hugely important. And I think some of the other things we do, whether it's employment or whether it's leadership training, all the different programs that Best Buddies offers, I think are key to ensuring that people with intellectual disabilities have success. And one day maybe we'll be a broadcaster, many of them. I'm sure I would love that.
I mean, some of the speeches I've heard, I mean, Michelle gives a great one. We've got a lot of girls here in the community, and boys too, who I listen to them, and I mean, they're so eloquent, they have so much to say, and this community is, I think, such an incredible part. It enriches our lives.
Yeah.
You always think if you volunteer, you're helping out someone else, but I have benefited way more than myself.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. Yeah. But I mean, if any community, every time I come to Las Vegas, this community is so generous and philanthropic. The people in this community are wonderful. So many of the other organizations have flourished here because of the generosity. But if there's any community that could accept someone in the news business that has intellectual disabilities, I think it would be Las Vegas. To get them on air, to play a small role, to be a broadcaster, to be a sports broadcaster,
I'd love that.
I think it'd be really fascinating. And to have the station do it, it'd be the first station
Michelle,
in the world.
Michelle, she's given lots of speeches. Maybe she could fill in for me one day. I'll take a vacation. I wouldn't mind if John come back to because she's so darn charming and cute, you know.
She's more
with all the boys here, but that's okay.
I think
give me a picture of Michelle to show me or keep referring to her. She'll be thrilled if we should,
put her on air.
Oh, absolutely.
But one day it's possible. I promise you, one day it's going to happen. And so many of the things that even my mom used to say, 30, 40 years ago when she started Special Olympics, you know, nobody thought they could swim in the pool. Nobody thought people with special needs were going to run the 100-yard dash or compete or run a marathon, you know, or hold a job in an integrated environment. And they're doing all those things.
Absolutely.
So I don't think anything's off limits, and certainly news broadcasting is not off limits. So you guys will be trailblazers.
I think it's a great idea. Yeah, and that's what's cool, too, is that we've just now had it for a couple years here in Nevada, which has been fantastic.
Yeah.
But it helps people. We've got middle schools. We've got junior high school. And then goes into, you know, friends in their 50s or 60s or 20s.
Absolutely.
And helps everybody.
Yeah, we launched Corporate Citizens here, where a company can start a Best Buddies chapter and the corporate employees can volunteer and mentor, which I think is an amazing way to instill social values and a sense of social responsibility in a corporate environment, which I think is hugely important. And so so many of the companies here have so many employees.
I
think what could be a better pool of volunteers than some of these great, huge casinos.
So, because you're here trying to, you're getting some great support from Las Vegas, right?
Yeah, Caesars has been great. MGM's been great. The Sands have been great. We're trying to do a bigger project with the Sands. And Mr. Adelson's been very generous to us over the years. And we're hopeful we're going to do something even larger and maybe be able to expand into Macau and maybe Singapore down the road.
Oh, my gosh. Incredible.
So lots of things brewing. Nothing done yet. But we'll have success any way you cut it.
And look at how much star support you have. I mean, we saw Tom Brady and Cindy Crawford, David Caruso. I mean, there's so many celebrities who've really championed this cause.
Yeah, it's been great. You know, we just came off of the biggest event in the history of our organization. We raised about $4.5 million last week with Tom Brady. In Boston, we had a full 100-yard football game with him at Harvard Stadium, and people rode their bikes 100 miles down to the Kennedy compound and my family's place down there on the Cape. And yeah, Cindy's been great, and my sister Maria runs chairs a huge ride out in California.
Yeah, she's
with
a
Clint
huge
Eastwood.
Supporter, yeah.
And we do a golf tournament with Clint Eastwood. So the celebrities have come out in a big way. But, you know, the reason they really come, it's not because of me or my family. It's really, you know, the buddies touch them in a really spiritual and emotional way, and I think they really resonates with so many people nowadays that are looking for something that's meaningful in their lives. And I think people with intellectual disabilities help us center our life, help us focus what's really important. And I think celebrities, almost of anybody out there, really need that or want that or feel that.
It totally grounds you because it's such honesty and it's such pure love. I feel and I think that you're helping with charities is so great. You go and you support a cause, you do a fun run. But when you become a friend to one person, and I feel like in the last 4 years, I've just been a part of one girl's life. And I think that sometimes it's more profound because you're just, if everybody just helped one person, can you imagine what it's going to be like, you know?
And, you know, as my mom used to say all the time, you know, one person can change the world. And we see that throughout history, you know, one person really can. So if you're doing it for one, you're doing it for many. And, you know, when I started, it was one buddy, and now we've got hundreds of thousands all over the world. So it's, you know, these things that really make a difference and people feel that they're having an impact, I think. You know, I always tell the young people, you know, and obviously I'm young still, but you know, never focus and worry about whether you're just impacting one human being. You don't have to get caught in the big picture of the world issues. You know, just do what you can do really, really well for one human being. You change that life, you've made a huge difference in the world.
Absolutely.
And
it's
and
so
you're
easy.
Doing that with your buddy.
Oh,
so
it's just, and the people, the commitment, are wondering what it takes to be a best buddy. It's just spending time with them a couple times a month. I mean, call them, text them, and plan a weekend event. Michelle and I are going to go see a movie this weekend, but we love to go get pedicure. We love girl spa day.
Oh, my God. I know. Your hair is so beautiful. I'm sure
you're
always at the hairdresser all the time.
Come on all the time. Seriously. Next time we'll bring Michelle on, she can do the interview. But she would giggle and laugh a lot.
I know. She should have been sitting here, unfortunately.
I know.
Next time.
Definitely so. But thank you so much
for
what you've done. Your mom, you guys have changed so many people's lives for the better. And the special needs community owes so much to you. It really is so appreciative.
Thank
so good luck today. Donors out there, please help support this great cause. And if you have any interest at all, just want to know more about becoming a best buddy, you can call me at the station here or go to the website and find out more information. So thank you so much, Aaron.
Yeah,
we so appreciate it.
My pleasure.